In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and God, Amen. As we talked for the last 2 weeks about the pattern of the readings, which is the love of God the Father, grace of His only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the communion and gift of the Holy Spirit, and we are in the first 4 months of the Coptic year, we talk about the love of God the Father. And from 2 weeks it was the caves, last week the sinner woman, and today the paralytic. Again, same pattern, the love of God the Father. The love of God the Father was manifested today not just in the healing of a sick man, a paralytic who has no hope to move, a big miracle of healing. It's more than that, that Jesus, He didn't just say to the paralytic, arise and take up your bed and go away, you are healed. But He, before that, He told him, your sins are forgiven. We're going to meditate on this story, and then we're going to talk specifically about the forgiveness. But when you talk about this, that many of the church fathers meditated on this passage or this story. And they emphasized the aspect of the divinity of Jesus Christ. When it comes to that man who came from the ceiling by the help of his four friends, Jesus, He told him, your sins are forgiven. And many of the fathers meditated on that it's a proof of the divinity of Christ. Who can forgive sin except God Himself? This was a proof that He is God Himself. One, He said it that by His own authority. And Saint John Chrysostom, he is saying on such an incident, he didn't pray or ask God, the Father, to give him forgiveness, to give the paralytic forgiveness. But He told him that your sins are forgiven directly from His mouth, which means He hold that authority. And no one hold that authority of forgiveness except God. This was a proof of the divinity of Christ. And the Pharisees got it right when they said, how can you forgive sin? Because they didn't accept that He is God incarnate. And they accused Him of doing blasphemy by saying that he forgives the man his sins. And they thought in their heart, how come that someone would say the sins are forgiven? This is only an attribute of God. This is an only authority of God. The only one who has that authority is God. And they thought that in their heart. And Saint Augustine was saying that God wanted to heal that man from the inside. He told him that your sins are forgiven even before the healing of his body, because He wanted to heal him, the real healing. And we're going to come to that later on. But the first point, the authority. Jesus didn't pray for God to forgive him, for God the Father to forgive him, but He told him that he is forgiven. He holds that authority, which means that He is God incarnate. This is number one. The second point is that he healed him first. He healed his soul by forgiving his sins, and then He healed his body. We in the Orthodox Church, we don't separate the body and the spirit, or the body and the soul. We deal holistically with the human nature. We need healing for our bodies, and we need healing for our soul. And the healing of our soul is the forgiveness. Saint Clement of Alexandria, one of the church fathers, he was the director of the School of Alexandria, and he has a great book called The Instructor. The Instructor. He was talking about Jesus Christ as the instructor, the wisdom of God. And he was saying that Jesus healed the man as far as the soul and as far as the body, because he deals with all our needs. But there should be priorities. And I think this would be the main point of my talk today. When the people dropped the man before Jesus Christ and they asked him to heal him, the first thing he said, your sins are forgiven. And when he knew, because he knows what's inside the heart, he knew that they are accusing him in their heart, saying, how come that man, he's just a man, and he is forgiving sins. He started to discuss this with them, and he asked them a very important question. He asked them, which is easier, to forgive sin or to give the healing of the body? And he has never given a clear answer to that question. But we should be knowing what is the answer. Which is easier? Which is easier? Healing the body. Healing the body is easier. I mean, if you come to someone in high school and we ask him, who is in high school? High school. No high schooler? Yeah, high schoolers. We asked you, would you like to, we're going to give you the same grade, AP Physics or take an elective? Whatever. Which would be easier? Elective, definitely. AP Physics is very terrifying, right? Okay, someone is offering you tutoring, and you're taking AP Physics and elective, and they can tutor you in anything, the AP Physics or the elective, what you're going to ask them to help you with? The AP Physics, because it's more difficult, right? So always we think of, we want to get the bigger, the higher, the better. I didn't get a chance to bring some chocolates with me. Yesterday I did it at Milwaukee. If we have small chocolates, candies, small candies, and big pack of chocolate, and we ask any kid to come and pick one, what do you think he's going to pick or she's going to pick?
The big one.
Right? We always look for the bigger, the higher, the better. That's how we are. Okay. Concerning Jesus Christ, he asked them, okay, I know that you are asking for healing, but I granted that man the forgiveness. Which is easier? It's easier to give the healing, but I'm giving you what is more difficult. I'm giving you what is more bigger, what is bigger than the healing of the body. I think we need to think of that idea. Whenever we ask for something, we should ask for the better, right? This is what we are doing. When we look to our prayers, we always look to the things of the body, things of this, the things that are temporary, the things of this world. Think of your prayer. I want you to think of your prayers. What are the main things you are praying for? Or we as priests, we people are coming always to ask for prayers. But what kind of prayers they are asking for? Healing. Big thing. If someone is going to a surgery, he would come and say, I need to be anointed by the oil because I have a surgery tomorrow. Okay? For passing a test, for being accepted in a job, for, and all the list, you know the list. But we don't ask that much for forgiveness. Because we are not asking for the bigger, even though we know that AP Physics and elective, the AP Physics is more difficult. If tutoring, I'm going to pick the AP Physics. If I'm going to pick a class, I'm going to take the elective. It's easier. So we know how to choose concerning the things of the earth. But why aren't we able to pick the big things? St. Isaac the Syrian has a nice quote saying that don't ask for the little things from the great. He's talking about God. Don't ask for the little things from the great. Because that's how you despise him. I mean, if you stand before God and you ask for the little things, again, I said before that St. Clement of Alexandria, he said that Jesus, he didn't say, I don't care about your body. I care about your soul. I forgive you your sins. I don't care about your body. He didn't say that. He dealt with him holistically. But on the other hand, he forgave him his sins first. That's why we were asked to pray for what first? The kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom of God, and everything will be added to you. I mean, it has a promise that everything will be added, but seek first. And by the way, we might use this to deceive God, or to try to deceive God, to ask for the kingdom of God, waiting for the things that are added. But he cannot be deceived. We should be very clear in asking for the kingdom of God, the forgiveness of sins. I think if there is a message from the gospel today is that the forgiveness of sins is number one. This is our main prayer. It should be our main prayer, our main request from God, the forgiveness of sins, the kingdom of God. He's gonna take care, he's taking care already of everything, of all of our needs. Yes, we have needs. We go through tribulations. We have diseases. We need God's grace in things that are tangible. But our salvation is more tangible than anything else. Yes, it is unseen. It's not the things we see, but or we touch, or we feel with our senses. But it is the most important thing. I think that the message of the gospel today is forgiveness of sins is number one. And again, Jesus didn't say, I don't care about your bodies. I don't care about your other needs. The last point I want to mention is the position of the Pharisees and the scribes. The Pharisees and the scribes, they are coming to the discussion or to the meeting with God. They have their own prejudices. They felt that he is threatening their position. I mean, if you look to some religions, the people go to the leader and they ask him, and he gives an answer because he knows about religion. And by the way, you might say, okay, don't we have something like that? We come to the priest and ask for advice. But it is not that the priest knows everything and the people doesn't know, they don't have the Holy Spirit. No, we don't have that idea. It's not that someone is dictating and knows the will of God and the people are in full darkness. We don't have that idea. The Holy Spirit, yes, works through the priest to give a spiritual advice to the people, but the people have the Holy Spirit as well. They are directed by the Holy Spirit, which is in them. That's a side note, but going back, in some religions, the people go to the leader of the religion and they ask for questions. And the answers are, he knows. He is the only one who knows about the religion. The people don't know anything. So Jesus, when he came and he started to confront the leaders of the Jews, they felt their position is threatened. And that's why they came to meet with him with the prejudice of, we need to confront him, make him look as a blasphemer and a heretic. So even though they have seen him forgiving the sins, healing the sick, and they didn't want to accept. What I'm trying to say, if the person doesn't want to believe, there is no way that he would believe. There is no way. I'm not saying we shouldn't, because we always ask. At work, I have people asking me questions, or they have certain beliefs. What can I tell them? How can I answer them? There is answers, and we should answer them. But there is no guarantee that the people would believe. Why? Because even at the time of Jesus Christ, he did all the miracles before the eyes of all the people. But there is people who believed and followed him And there is people who said he's a blasphemer. So it's about the faith. Even atheism now, I think that atheism now is like a religion, a new religion. It's not that the atheists are not people who disbelieve or they don't believe in God. I think they believe in the rejection of God. And their belief in the rejection of God is some kind of faith they have. That's why when they are coming to talk about when the God is brought into any discussion, they are not open to listen. Some of them, I'm not giving general statement. I mean, like the scribes and the Pharisees here, they have seen Jesus Christ granting forgiveness, they have seen him granting healing, but they didn't believe. So I mean, it depends on the person. That's why we are coming to church and we are asking for God to give us that deep belief in him. We believe that in his powerful healing of the body, and more important, the healing of the soul from sins. This is the faith we need to ask for God to give us, that it becomes more and more, that it increases, it multiplies, like the guy who went to Jesus and told him, I believe in you, but please help my disbelief. How can he believes and he have disbelief? His belief, his faith is not enough, but he is asking God to help him to believe more and more. Like the disciples, when they asked God and told them, please help us to believe in you more and more. Believe in you more and more. I think this is an important message. Two things. The forgiveness of sins is number one. Number two, that belief, it does not depend on what we see. It depends on the inside, that we believe on the power of God, who is granting healing, and who is the healing of the body, and the healing, and more important, the healing of the soul from sin, and glory be to God forever.